win it. So he sat next to me. It's his icky dog. Bless him. So, hello, hello. Well, today, I'd like to take a look at some old photos, if I may. From a past life that I used to have. Ah, nostalgia. So, what have we got here? That's my cousin's funeral, bless her. It was a very hippie event. She was a lovely lass. She died when she was 44 of brain cancer. Nice! But I loved her to bits. She was a great old bird. And that's my family. That's my dad. He's gone now, sadly. That's my mum. She's still with me. She's 91. And I don't know who, actually, to be honest with you. I'm not cluing you. There's a couple of cats, though. There's cats there. Don't know what they're doing. These are friends of mine that were at college when I was first at college. That's Judd, that's Kathy, that's Phil, and that's Anita. And that's Judd with my best mate, Jerry. I'm still in touch with him. Yeah, they were nuts, these people. They were rather amusingly nuts, is all I can say. And that's me. That's me in the back there. Juliet, the other ones I've mentioned. I don't remember this chap's name. That's Katrina. She's lovely. They were lovely people. There's Phil. Lovely people. There's Katrina again. Really lovely people. And anyway, my first wife used to work in the film industry, in the movie industry, mostly for Pinewood Studios. And this chap here, I can't remember his name now, actually. This he was a director, cameraman director. He was studying at the at some college where my wife used to occasionally teach, you know, because obviously you're not constantly working in film. And this guy, Dave, I got to know him through my wife, and he said, we're doing a film, we're doing a movie, you know, you'd be perfect for it. And I remember this very pretty young girl was the starlet, who I had to kiss, and I thought, well, you know, it's a tough job, but somebody's got to do it, you know. So I got roped in, basically. I got roped in to this kind of student production movie where that's me looking a right twat with this very pretty young lass. That's my, obviously I'm trying to do a Lewis Collins there, you know. I'm trying my bloody hardest to look like Lou Collins, you know, which is not going to ever work. But, no, it was fun. It was good. It was really good fun. We had laughs, put it that way. There's me. I think my face says it all when I've got that young girl on my lap. I shamish money, Benny. So there's a good mate of mine. There's a really good mate of mine. I won't mention any names from these parts because some people might not want to be recognised that way. That's me rolling a naughty. That's me when I used to go surfing. That's a longboard, 9'6". Really good board that was, actually, made by Mike Pete in North Devon. That's the break. It was a good break, that was. I enjoyed it a lot, innit? That's my mate, who enjoyed it a lot. That's Darren, and that's John, I think his name was, from Surfed Out, which I believe is still going. They're in North Devon. This was a holiday we had in Lanzarote, on one of our many surfing trips. You can see I used to smoke in those days, back in the bad old days. And that was the van. So there's me with a dog. We kind of inherited this dog. It was just that we were feeding it. And there's a bit of a funny story behind this, actually, because when I went on the holiday, I said to Darren, I said, "Oh, sounds lovely, you know, I'm up for it. I'm up for going on holiday and on a surfing holiday to Lanzarote, fantastic." And it was Darren, sorry, Darren, not, what did I call him before? I don't remember. That was Darren, and then was Justin. But there were some great breaks. You can see that's a good size wave that. That's at least shoulder high, that one. Sweet. And so we went off on this holiday. And I said to, look at the fashion. Look at, that's me. Can you believe, what a dick. the Czech dick. But now the we went off on this holiday. That was the group, and I jokingly said, "Well, all we need really, it's a nice sweet wave that. All I really need now is a blonde and a brunette, you know." And Darren said, "Well," he said, "it's funny you should say that because the cottage that you're in, you're sharing." That's Darren there. That's my mate. "You're sharing with a blonde," and that was her. And she was, I mean, come on. I was sort of like, there they are. The blow she holds. They were lovely kids. They were only in their teens. They were 18. I think she was 19. I think she was 18. And we were obviously a lot older. And I didn't feel like I wanted to kind of go there with them because I was, about, you know, sort of 6 years older than them. And I thought, no, it's a bit of a... not a good thing to do. That's my old bus. That's my old Westfalia Volkswagen bus. You could lift the old roof up and make two more beds inside. So there it is. POU649S. It was. It's still out there somewhere, the old darn thing. That's me again, Mr. Fashion, with a stick. In surfing, we call that a stick. And that's that lovely lass. I can't remember her name now, and that's the dog that we kind of, I mean, it must have been gutted when we left because it was fed every day. It was a dearest little dog as well. I do like dogs, it's probably, you know, so that's Lanzarote, isn't it? And that's us surfing about different people that were on the holiday, you know, doing the surfing, isn't it? Good fun. I used to love surfing, I must say. I was quite good at it as well. I mean, don't get me wrong, I wasn't a bloody Hawaiian big wave rider or anything like that, you know. I'm not the Duke Kahanamoku, but at the same time, I enjoyed what I did, which was sort of shoulder height, waist height, head height, even as far as could go. Surf, you know. And there it is. This, as I said, this little dog followed us everywhere. It just was like a pal. I wanted to take it home with me, bless its heart. I couldn't bear to see it go, and it was squeaking when I left him, because obviously it knew I was a goner. I presume that it just kind of, you know, got friendly with anyone that was, that's me, the scrawner. And I presume it just got friendly with anyone that was out there that would do its business, you know, that would give it food sort of thing. There it is on the beach. It was even waiting for me to come back in, you know, and I used to just paddle out. It would be there. That's Darren with his long board. That's me with my old spiky dog. Spiky dog. That's spiky. These photos are dotting about a bit, actually. That's my dad with Spike. They used to sleep together. It was so funny. My old dad used to sleep with Spikey. I don't know what that one is of. Oh, that's my mate with Spikey. That was when he probably came to visit us in Poland. It's my mum, dad, and my ex-missus. That's my ex-missus with Spoik, Spoikatoik. And that's him chewing a ball. He was a lovely dog, Spike. He was really, really lovely. Very energetic. I mean, he's always on the run, you know, on the foot. That he could be nasty, though. Look at that. Zoltan, the Hound of Dracul. Come to me, Zoltan. And that was him in front of the fire. He used to kind of cook his brains in front of the fire. That's my ex-missus with the little spike. That's my mum and dad in the beautiful mountains of Poland. Well, there's graffiti wherever you go, innit? I'll whisk through because these ones are a bit personal. Those are a bit personal. Them ones are a bit personal. Some of the ones I'm going low down below. Low down below the hole. That's the... Yeah. So that's the Baltic. That's the Baltic coast. I don't know what we've got here. What else have we got? I'll put you on Jimmy for a minute whilst I flick through, because obviously some of these are... I mean, there's no nudity or anything, but it's a bit sort of... Some of them are a bit private, if you know what I mean, by privacy. So I launch into these videos and they're not really... So there you go, that's me. And well, I used to have long hair in those days. And that's my ex. we're walking through the air, as it were. What have we got here? So that's at the top of the Snieżka mountain, that's 1,602 metres high, or three, if you're on the Czech side, because their sea level is lower for some reason, I don't know why. But that's me up there, as it were. And that's me pointing out my birth sign in this kind of place where you can see how high it is. I mean, it's high up, it's up the top of the world, it is. Lovely. I liked it a lot. I used to be taken up there by a tour guide that was a very decent fellow. Very, very decent fellow. Oh, that's one of my jokes. I always just like playing practical jokes. What that is it's an old camembert. it's an old camembert container, you know, and I teased my niece once. I said, oh, look at this. Look what I found in that. And she thought it was hilarious. So she, far from being frightened, she just thought it was just stupid, hilariously funny. Bless her. Because she was far cleverer than me. And I she realised it was my own finger, you know, that just stuck to the bottom of the... with ketchup, with chips, you know. So there you go. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. It's just something, a bit of my past. You can learn a bit more about me if you're interested. If you're not, then don't watch it. Thanks ever so much. Cheers.